Hello everyone. Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on cost of goods sold. Now, when you hear the cost of goods sold, there's two things that comes in mind: net profit or the gross profit and the sales. So once you deduct, when you have your net sales and when you deduct your cost of goods sold, you get gross profit. As you have a example over here, this is one template which shows you how the profit and loss account things work and how cost of sales or the cost of goods sold has been recorded. So let's begin. Cost of goods sold is the cost that directly relates to the production of the goods and sold in the company. So in other words, COGS is accumulation of the direct cost, remember one thing, that went into the goods sold by your company. So this amount includes the cost of any materials that have been used in the production of goods, and also it includes the direct labor cost used to produce the said wealth. So it's not only the direct cost, but it also includes the direct labor. Now, labor cost includes the direct labor as well as the indirect labor. So the cost of materials, which is the next thing, the direct cost, cost of materials, see, you can say DM, includes the direct cost like raw materials, as well as like supplies, indirect materials, where non-incidental amounts of these supplies are maintained. The taxpayers must keep inventories of the supplies for the income tax purposes, charging them to expenses or goods sold or used rather than as purchased. Direct labor, DL, direct labor cost are the wages that have been paid. This is sort of all the wages that have been paid to those employees who spend all the time working directly on the product being manufactured. So indirect labor costs are basically the wages paid to other factory employees involved in the production process. So the cost of payroll, which is the next thing, cost of payroll, taxes and fringe benefits are generally included in the direct labor cost, but may be treated as overhead cost, which is known as OH. It excludes any indirect expenses. So this thing should not be a part of it. Indirect expenses such as like sales cost, cost of marketing. So in the cost of goods sold income statement presentation, the goods sold is basically subtracted from the net revenues to arrive at the gross margin of the business. That's what we saw over here, the net sales, and we deduct cost of sales, which by the end result we receive as gross profit. Now in the service industry, this include payroll cost. Okay, they include payroll cost, labor charges, benefits for the employees who are directly involved in providing these services. So any cost that is associated with indirect expenses are excluded from the COGS, such as like, you know, you can say marketing expenses, overhead and shipping fees. Like for example, of the cost of sales for laptop, the makers would include cost of material, that is, you can say direct materials required for the parts of the laptop, plus the labor cost used to assemble the parts of the laptop together. So the cost of spending the laptop to dealers and the cost of labor incurred to sell the laptops would be excluded. Also, the cost incurred on the laptop that are in stock, remember this thing, during the year will not be included when calculate the cost of goods sold, whether the costs are direct or indirect. So in other words, you can say this includes the direct cost of the producing goods or services that are sold to the customers. Now, let's learn the next thing, that is impact on COGS, that is impact on the cost of goods sold. See, you can see the cost of goods sold can also be impacted by the type of the costing methodology or the method that has been used to derive the cost of ending inventory. So there are one of the three methods for recording the cost of sales inventory during the period. One is called the FIFO method, first in first out, then is LIFO, that is last in first out, and there is an average cost method which is called as weighted average method, which is called VAM. So let's consider the impact for the first one, first in first out. Under this method known as FIFO, the first unit added to the cost of the goods sold inventory is assumed to be the first one used. Thus, in inflationary condition environment where the prices are increasing, you can say that this trend to result lower cost of goods sold. So the cost of goods sold will go down, or it will be in a lower end being charged to the cost of goods sold. The next is LIFO. Under this method is known as last in first out, LIFO, right? To the cost of goods sold, inventory is assumed to be the first one used. Thus, in inflationary environment where you can say the prices are going down, right? Where the prices are increasing, that this tends to result in higher cost of goods sold. See, you can see the opposite impact, right? The next is weighted average method, or known as average cost method. The average cost is calculated by dividing the total cost of the goods ready for the sale by the total number of units that are ready for sale. This gives a weighted average unit cost that is applied to the units available in the closing inventory at the end of the period. So, let's understand the next thing, that is how to calculate the cost of goods sold, how this thing is calculated. Well, in order for how to calculate the cost of goods sold, we must be familiar with the very first three familiar with the three terms. The first is beginning inventory. Okay, this is basically the total cost of every product in your inventory at the start of the year. This should be exactly the same as your ending inventory from the last year. Second, that's the second term, is the additional inventory. Right, this is the total cost of the goods sold inventory that you have purchased during the year. The third is your ending inventory. When you talk about ending inventory, this is the total cost of the goods sold inventory at the end of the year. So the formula goes something like this. The beginning, that is the first, as you can see over here, plus any addition, that is the second, is equal to, when you do 1 plus 2, you will get the amount as what is the amount that we sold, what we sold. And when you add in this, the ending, that is what we end up with, you get, therefore, that is the cost of goods sold. So it's like the beginning inventory plus you do the addition to the inventory less the ending inventory, you get your cost of goods sold. So beginning inventory plus addition less ending, that gives you your cost of goods sold. That's the formula for COGS. Now, let's understand this whole thing with the help of an example. Inventory, let's say, at recorded at the beginning of the fiscal year, let's say in 2017, is 2000. So, this is inventory at the big, I'm just writing BEG. Additional inventory, that is add inventory purchased during the fiscal year 2017 and 18, let's say, is 1500. And the ending inventory recorded at the end of the fiscal year of 2018, let's say, is 1000. So this should be really very simple. Let's say calculate the cost of the goods sold. So as per the cost of the sales formula, cost of goods sold, COGS, should be really very simple over here. So that is nothing. It's a beginning plus addition, and you deduct the ending, you get your cost of goods sold, which is your $2,500. Therefore, $2,500 is the cost of the goods sold. Now, calculate the cost of the sales varies depending on whether the business is retail, wholesale, manufacturing, or service business. So, if we talk about retail and wholesale, calculate, you can say, the cost of sales during the reporting period involves the beginning and the ending inventories. This, of course, includes the purchase made during the reporting period. But when we talk about manufacturing, it involves finished goods, very important, inventory. Plus, you have raw materials, inventories, raw material inventories, goods in process inventories, direct labors, and direct factory overhead cost. So, in this case of service business, the revenue is being derived from the activities of the individuals rather than the sale of the product. And hence, calculating the cost of goods sold is smaller task, you can say, due to the low level of use of the material required to earn the income. Let's understand the next thing in this particular tutorial. What is the importance of COGS? Now, the COGS is important component of the financial statement. It is deducted from the company's revenue, which we saw at the very initial inception stage, to arrive at the gross profit. So the gross profit is a measure that evaluates how effectively the company is managing its operating cost in the production process. So cost of goods sold used by analysts, investors, managers to forecast the company's gross profit, you can say. So if your COGS, if your cost of goods sold, if this particular thing increases, your GP, that is the gross profit, will decrease. And the vice versa will go about. Do minus and do plus over here. This is vice versa case. So businesses therefore will be able to keep their cost of goods sold low so that their net profit will be higher. Sometimes they do it for the window dressing. Cost of goods sold may be used internally to measure the company's success and to determine when the prices on a particular product needs to be increased. So the goods sold can be also be used to set profit margins as the basis of your product's prices. Let's understand the next thing is, what is the limitation of COGS? This is easily be adjusted by allocating to the inventory higher manufacturing cost than was actually incurred. So adjusting the amount of the inventory in closing stock at the end of the accounting period will lead to overvaluing inventory in stock, falling to write off outdated inventory and etc. When the cost of sales inventory is purposely inflated, cost of goods sold will be reduced, which in turn will lead to higher actual gross profit margin and hence inflated net income.
If you have learned and liked the video, if you think that if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone. Cheers.